Bureaucrats have been blamed for a badly positioned alarm cutting water to Sydney's biggest hospital. Pumps failed at Westmead, disrupting surgery and forcing patients and staff to use bedpans for toilets.
Westmead Hospital forced into its very own emergency. For just over 3 hours yesterday, there was no water.
I just went to the toilet and no water at all.
No toilets or showers for patients and staff.
We have disposable bedpans and disposable pans which the patients use, which we dispose of as clinical waste.
It also forced the cancellation of 6 elective surgeries and meant 5 dialysis patients had to be transferred to Auburn Hospital.
This is a serious incident and this is unprecedented.
I'm scratching my head like many others. I'm waiting on the report.
Concerns also over hand hygiene, but emergency surgery went ahead with sterile bottled water. It was Gillian Skinner's first major embarrassment as the minister overseeing the system, but she blamed the old government.
16 years of Labor, they didn't really invest as well as they should have.
But then she and bureaucrats blamed a badly positioned alarm which went off too late when water levels were critically low. These tanks in the basement are now being closely monitored. Sydney Water has told the hospital that supply from its end was operating as normal. So now hospital maintenance teams are checking internally to find the exact cause of the problem. 10 News understands the solution could involve re-engineering how water is connected to the hospital. Until then, no guarantees it won't happen again.
The kind of problem that occurred yesterday can be resolved by fixing some valves and pressure points.
Josh Murphy, 10 News.